Well, first things first, before we start with our Q&A portion, we're going to have a special lecture from Ms. Crinkle Yap about the history of anime conventions in the Philippines. Yeah. Let's please give a hand to Ms. Crinkle Yap.
Hi everyone, so I'm Crinkle. I'm also an alumna of this org, UP Anime, from batch 2007. And I was actually chosen for this lecture because it was actually part of my thesis from BA Art Studies. So I'll be actually giving like a survey of the anime conventions here in the Philippines. Not so much, I tried doing it chronologically, but realized that we've actually expanded more than just time bound. And anyway, so before the big conventions, these kinds of gatherings or events started with the card game Magic the Gathering, which is Novelty Entertainment was the one distributing these cards, and they decided to make a big event of mostly just merchandise selling and buying, because there was a time when they were doing big tournaments and they couldn't fit in the shops that they had, so they had to rent in like the mega trade halls in SM Mega Mall. There was also film showing, so anime at Orky, as in UP Architecture, and anime review by Anima Anime. These both of them were film showings that were open to the public. And so basically the Magic the Gathering was in the 90s, and then we head to the 2000s. So the first one was Anime Explosion. This was actually in partnership of AXN, Art Farm Asia, and Anima Anime. Anima Anime was the main organizer. And this was the start of all the anime conventions, because it brought the biggest guest during that time, which is Yu Watase, the mangaka of Fushigi Yugi, which is super popular because it was featured in GMA. And then in 2001, that's the start of with all of the conventions. So these are pictures of from the events Art from Asia, it's an anime festival, and Anime on Ice. So Art from Asia is a animation studio before. And then AXN obviously is the channel before they made a specific channel for anime, which is Animax. And yeah, before Yuri on Ice, there was Anime on Ice back in 2001. And this is, next slide please. Yes. So this one is the Culture Crash Comics Convention, which are shortly called as C3 Con. So this is the con where the programs that you see now in present conventions was able to formalize the structure. So for example, the competitions, the catwalk, the merchandise alley. So this is also a good convention where they were able to promote local talent. So if you guys don't know, do you guys know what Culture Crash is? Okay, some of you do. you guys are very young, yes. Suddenly this panel felt really old. Culture Crash was a comic locally made here in the Philippines. It's one of the first comics that adapted the anime style or manga style in their comic. So for them to pull off such a big event was also such a wonderful start for anime conventions. And we also feature here picture of Ashley and Elodia Gosengkau, who some have said was the con that started their career as cosplayers. and also featuring Kuya Robert. Anyway, he's the one in the bottom picture. Next. So this one is the Level Up Live. This is a convention mostly for, well, obviously for games, because of the popularity of the Ragnarok Online game. They were able to make a big event of the game by having a game tournament and then adding the elements that were in the previous con, so the merchandising, the cosplay, live bands, and such. Next. Okay, ToyCon obviously is still going strong, but they started in 2002. So this is mainly a merch con, so it's really just about buying and selling. But lately they've added the cosplay competition as well. So I don't think it is a formal place to have to don cosplay, but yeah, it's just recent that they were able to a competition. Next is the Comic Con. So they started in 2005. This was organized by artists then. They were a group of artists that wanted to also showcase local talent. So this one started also in the Bahay ng Alumni in UP Diliman. And now it's in a bigger venue, so Bayanihan Center. And so far, I think Comic-Con features more very established artists in the Philippines. And they have also started doing IndieCat, so showing independent works, like and smaller works like zines or comics. And they started in 2012. So this one is the Hataw Hanap Hero Convention. So I'm also featuring conventions made by big media groups or media groups. So this is probably part of your childhood as well. Hero is a channel that was made by ABS-CBN, and they also decided to make their own conventions, and it started in 2005. So same, almost the same ever since with Culture Crash Comics Convention, with bands, with merchandising, with cosplay competitions. I think they also had like a dubbing contest as well, because since they did feature the anime in Filipino, they did encourage others to try it as well. Next, please. Okay, so in the next slides are actually conventions that cater to a more specific interest. So they may not be small in terms of venue, but rather it's not as broad as the other conventions that I've featured. So we can start with New Worlds. It's actually a sci-fi convention. They started in 2003, but it's pretty short-lived. So they only had five events in until 2007. And what replaced them was NextCon. So that's another sci-fi convention here in the Philippines. But so far, I've seen that they only had an event until 2016. Then we also have an event for Mecha. So that's the Mecha Gaming and Technology Convention. So here, they cater to specific interests of those who do toy building. Is that the right term?
They actually featured Gunpla, and at the same time, they held a tournament, the Gundam. I forgot what game is that. Gundam tournament, where you can actually choose any mecha or in any Gundam franchise, and then you like fight each other. So, and not only that, they're also featuring indie games, and and then basically it's also a place where clubs, like tech clubs from different schools, showcase. Showcase their wares, and then also to recruit members into their clubs. So it's actually a pretty small convention, but it's well, basically to the point. It really, shows their shows their intention and their wares regarding what they are as a convention.
Thank you. Actually, I don't mind if you want to correct anything from the info that I'm giving, because it's pretty much just an overview, so you can add info in the beginning. Anyway, so the next one in the picture is a group called Ongako Society. So they actually organized gigs that where they covered J-pop, J-rock music. So that was around 2003 until 2011. Next, please. There. So there's also Lights Out and Blush Gun. So before Blush Gun, there was Lights Out, and they started in 2004 until their last con was in 2010, and then Blush Gun was founded in 2012, and they do events biennially. So 2012, 2014, they had a small event 2015, 2016, and then the recently concluded one in this year. Next, please. Okay, so these are also, there are also events that are made by student organizations. So yeah, I'm pretty sure one of them looks familiar. Yeah. So, which I found funny because the one made by Blush Gun is 2018. The one made by UP AME was made in 2007. So yeah, some things don't really change. Anyway, with Tamashikon was made by Nihon Kenkyukai, an org from LaSalle, and they had an event, Tamashi Convention, in 2015 and in 2016. Next. I think medyo bugi yung PowerPoint. So yeah, there are other conventions that I wanted to feature, but I'll just mention it in passing. I'm sorry, you have to use your imagination. But one of them was supposed to be Cosmania by cosplay.ph. Don't worry, I'm pretty sure we're gonna learn more about them. And then there's also the Ozine Fest. That one also is also a pretty big event, and I consider them as a media based group because of the Taozine that they have. And they actually started in 2005. Then the ones that I showed you in the various events, one of them was the maid cafes that were also established before. So for example, like Talking Apples and Doki Saten. So yeah, we did have that stint for a while. And then there was Magenta. It's a Mystic Messenger event and cafe. So who plays Mystic Messenger? Okay. Nahiya pa kayo. Hindi na ba sa Mystic Messenger? Oh, sorry. Hindi ko alam. Yeah, but this one was pretty recent.
I have a friend of mine, he's part of the Magenta team, I think. Cosplay name is Yuri Nanami. He cosplay Zen Ryo at times.
So, yeah, so that's considered a smaller event. Smaller in the sense it's very specific to one fandom. And with that, obviously, is the Born to Make History Yoikon that was recently concluded. It's very popular. Very surprised that they got two halls by a new. So very good. And who else did we miss? Oh, we also missed, do you guys know Toshin?
Yes.
Toshin, who used to be Tojin from Ateneo. They're an org from Ateneo, so they also have their own events. They have their sorry, I'll go to you, CC, to know them more.
Yeah, their event is called Token, or Token Convention. It's usually held in the open field in Ateneo, but sometimes they branch out in other buildings, such as, if I remember correctly, they had one in World Trade, if I'm not mistaken. But usually it's just held in Ateneo. It's usually also a merchant one, more than an event. But lately they're trying to have a small events in their convention as well.
Are they open to the public? Okay, that's good. They're not specific to their own school. And also with them is PNU NAMI. So they had the recently concluded TsunamiCon. It's an org in PNU. And other orgs that are also into anime and manga is Soma from UPLB, Omakai from UPM. So there was also before Tomase no Taku. So that was a UST-based one. And I'm so sad that I can't show it, but there are actually also conventions outside Manila. So for example, is Otaku Fest in Cebu. They have also, they've been doing conventions since 2008. So they're pretty established in their own city. There's also the 14th. IBMS Baguio Invitational. So it's actually also a cosplay competition, but in the Baguio chapter. So that's going to be held in SM Baguio. And also there's also Mask Fest in SM City Bacolod. So yeah, there are actually scattered events all over the Philippines and not just in Manila. So that's pretty much it. I hope that gives you the scope of the anime conventions here in the Philippines. Do you have time? Do you have time? Okay. So with that, I'd also like to say that specifically my research before was mostly on the anime fairs. So I'd like to just give you a slideshow of the past fairs that we've had until Anime Fair X. So, yeah, you can start. So that's the first pop, the first month of Nakame. Next one is Kame Odet. So these all started in 2004. 2004, this is 2005. Anime Matsuri is 2006. So far, all of these events were made in the Bahit in the Bahit. Ang bahay ng atin. And the next one is, okay, this is an Ami Matsuri picture. So we've also featured bands before. So yes, this one is in the 2007 event. It's called Amigahon Sai. Its theme was the school fair. So if you realize it, starting Ami Matsuri, UPM has started incorporating themes to help organize these events yearly. Next, please. So these are mostly just pictures of Amiga Kansai. That's it. We also had fan art contests and smaller booths, like pretty much like a school fair. Yeah, these were the uniforms of the organizers. So yeah, we used to have pretty red uniforms. So yeah, we had a cosplay competition, we had bands. Yes, that was also the first year we had a cafe. So this on the second floor. Yeah. This is Ame 8th Avenue. So the theme here was about Harajuku fashion. or the Harajuku subcultures. So yeah, we made signages out of rubber foam. We had tarps. Booths were pretty small back then. We had just tables. We also made billboards out of rubber foam, PVC pipe. So these prize booths were always a staple in the anime fairs. Can just speed it up. That was we were trying to do a map of the whole event using rubber foam. And a pathway leading to the event. So we were pretty big. We were able to decorate bahay ng alumni with pretty much doing a lot of DIY. Smaller games. I think we were trying to copy the old signage in Harajuku. Also with that half art thing, yeah. So that's, I don't know if you recognize the members here. They recognize him. Let's not mention it anymore. He used to be a member, obviously. Yeah, he was part of the cosplay cafe. So yeah, we always had to, I think there was also a point we were also encouraging people to write fanfic for a contest. So that's how the crowd got before. I think that was just at the start. So around 12 o'clock, the gates were opening. Yeah. Sorry. Sorry, Dan. Yeah, that's how crowded it got with these events. I remember some of them were painted, so because of the heat, the crowd, and the costume that they were in, we always had to have a first aid booth. So the catwalk was also decorated when we tried. We also had that Freedom Wall, so anyone who could visit was able to put a comment. So pretty, still like a school fair, but it was themed with what we saw in anime and manga. This was, that one was a speed dating booth. So aside from the cafe, we also tried that. Never happened again. Really? When?
You did it again yesterday.
Back then?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
We had to close it down.
Oh, that's why. It was short-lived as well. Oh, yeah. Yeah, eventually our decor got destroyed during the catwalk. I guess it comes with it doing your own decorations. Okay, next is Aminoji Day. So at this time, the feedback we received from 8th Avenue was, your venue is too small, it's too crowded, we can't get in. So we decided to go out of Bayan ng Alumni, UP itself, and look for a different venue. So this was held in a venue, and Aminoji Day is based on the theme of feudal Japan. So because of the change in venue, we had to make sure people would know how to get there, so we made a map. I remember we also made a video. We made a video where it was starring, where Haruhi, starring as Haruhi and the cast of Haruhi Suzumiya in Filipino. Yeah, just to make sure people could get to our event.
It's somewhere in the internet, but you can't find it.
Oh, okay. Hey, next. So yeah, the themes were more... So the cafe turned into a tea room. Huh, looks familiar. So these are also the booths that you can find. Okay, next. Amatrak 10 is actually the celebration of the 10th year of UP Amen, but it's not the 10th event. So that's the difference. So with Track 10, the main or the blanket theme was music, but we decided to incorporate past themes by cutting the space into zones, different zones, featuring like a maturi or a school fair and the Harajuku, just to also commemorate the past fairs that we did. So this was the sumo booth. You still play the sumo booth? Okay, good. That was the cafe. Dating game. Dating speed. That was the speed dating area.
Speed dating area, speed
game. Okay, there. And we also have put up tarps to show past events. So signages everywhere. Yeah, people just had fun in that booth, so... Oh, it's Peter Robert again. The next one was Ame Monogatari. So, I guess Japanese folklore was the main event. I mean, theme, sorry. And we had this small Zen garden at the entrance. Right, putting statue-looking dragons around. So this was in World Trade. Yeah, this started in World Trade. The previous Amir Captain was in SMX. This one is One Up, I mean One Up, where the theme was games. And this was one of also the most well-attended events that we had. This was also the event where we were able to have a guest, who is Reika Arikawa. We still had the booths, like the sumo booth, the cafe. We also were able to invite gaming companies, so some could have their tournament there. So we dressed, that Snorlax thing is the sumo suit. We dressed them up as Pokemon, so you know, while playing sumo suit, you can just feel what we do to them. That's inside the cafe, the tavern. That was the line, just outside, with Reika. So she was signing her cards. She was trying out the fish booth. Because she was able to walk around before the whole thing opened. She tried. This was part of our duty or obligation as a Cal org to feature. Yeah, this was in the line. Really long line until outside. Yeah, until outside of the event. So yeah, small booths, photo booths. Gaming. these are the cosplay competitions. Yeah. So this is the last event that I have pictures of. It's the Amifair X, where the org decided to not have a big theme and decided to have a two-day event instead of just one. This was also for we were co-organizers with World Bex. So yeah. You can speed that up. I don't think there's much pictures to it. I think there are a lot of limitations with this particular event. So with doing conventions, it's not always a success. It's not always going to be a success. There will be areas that you'll have to talk about and further improve in the next one. Hey, Robert. I love pictures of you. I think that's the last one. So, yeah. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to talk about the short history.